good versus evil. This is the struggle of truth versus falsehood. We are here because Barack Obama tells nothing but lies. We are here because
the mainstream media tells nothing but lies. And we stand for life and truth and good versus evil. And so it's very important that we cut through and we challenge the lies that they tell everywhere and every time they tell them. And our next speaker is one of the great masters of telling the truth and cutting through the lies of the Islamic Jihad. Go to YouTube and look for this man, and you will see him speaking in Arabic on Al Jazeera and facing down Islamic spokesmen who say Jerusalem is a Muslim city, and showing them Jerusalem isn't even mentioned in your Quran, and quoting chapter and verse in the Arabic. He cuts through the lies with truth, and he is a great international warrior for truth. Please welcome, all the way from Israel, 25 years in IDF military intelligence, Dr. Mordechai Kedar.
First of all, I would like to make a comment. Whatever I am going to say from this honorable stage is not about the Islamic world, because the world is full of many millions of peaceful Muslims whom nobody has anything against them, who worship Allah, pray five times a day, go to Hajj once in a lifetime, and perform the commandments of Islam. They are not radical, they have no harm, don't make harm to anybody, and nobody should have anything against them. We are not talking about them. We are talking about radical people who turn life of Muslims and others alike to hell. And this is what we are about. Having said that, I would like to ask you guys, who heard 2 months ago about the massacre of the Yazidis? 2 months ago, nobody, because there was no massacre. Who was surprised by this massacre? Who knows about massacres? So the question is actually, where this culture of massacres started in Islam? Well, we have no other choice but to go to the history registered by Muslims. Listen to this. The first massacre, which we'll mention in a short list, the year of 627, the Jews of Khaybar and Bani Qurayza were slaughtered, 800 people in one day. Later on, in the conquering of the Sham, means the Middle East or the Levant, dozens of massacres happened during the 7th century.
Samarkand. The massacre of Samarkand, 720. The same year, the massacre in Sindh, where today Pakistan is, hundreds of thousands of Buddhists were massacred. Egypt, in 739 and 750. Byzantium, 806. Massacres in Greece, the year of 838. Spain, 862. Sicily, in the city of Syracuse, the year of 878. Saloniki, in Greece, in the year 903. Armenia, the Armenians were massacred already at the year of 940. Again in Greece, in
53 and 4. India in 10-11, 10-13, 10-19, 10-26. Every year of these witnessed mass massacre in these places. Armenia again, 10-49. Granada in Spain, 10-66. Tunisia, Tunis, 11-59. Again in India, 11-93. Antakya, 12-68. Egypt, with the Copts, 12-65-6. Isfahan, where Iran is, 13-81. Many, many other cities in Persia until the year of 1400. Constantinople, 1453. And so on and so on. Nobody should be surprised by the massacre of the Yazidis, which takes place these very days. Later on, the blood libel of 1840, formerly the massacre in Sudan, 1852, by Hajj Umar. Christians in Damascus was massacred in 1860, in Bulgaria, 1875. Jews in Fez were massacred in April 1912, and so forth. Now, what is standing behind the radical Islam in the modern era? It starts in 1928, the establishing of the Muslim Brotherhood. And this is their logo, the Muslim Brotherhood logo, which has three words. The brothers, the Muslim brothers, and down there, one word, which is from the Quran, and master, means recruit. It is master, means recruit. What is this? This is taken from one verse. This word appears once in the Quran, only once, in chapter 8, verse 60. وَاعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ تُرْهِبُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَ اللَّهُ وَعَدُوَكُمْ. Part of the verse. Who didn't understand this? So I'll translate it for you. And this is a translation of Dawood. Master against, this is the word, and master against them, all the men and cavalry at your command, so that you may strike terror into the enemy of God and your enemy. This is a commandment in the Quran. Master all what you need in order to strike terror in the hearts of your enemy. However, there is another translation and exegesis which is disseminated here in this country in academic institutions. I personally got this book, the Noble Quran, no, Interpretation of the Meanings of the Noble Quran, given to me for free by the Muslim Student Association in an institution which is 12 miles from here. Academic institution. And on this verse, which I just read, the version is a little bit different. The meaning is different. And make ready against them all you can of power, including steeds of war, and now in brackets, tanks, planes, missiles. Heard about Gaza? Missiles, artillery, and brackets, to threaten thereby the enemy of Allah and your enemy. And this book, which recommends the Muslims to prepare tanks, planes, missiles, artillery against the enemy of the radical Muslims, is disseminated for free in this country. Somebody is insane in this country. So this is actually the Muslim Brotherhood, which takes its ideas from this verse according to this meaning, and this is why the Muslim Brotherhood took this word wa'iddu, wa'iddu here, which appears again only once in the whole Quran, from this verse. So what do they mean? A peaceful organization. Just look at the swords. One sword is for the hugs and one sword is the kisses. Right? Right. Okay. So this is the logo of the Muslim Brotherhood. Now this Muslim Brotherhood is no more than a parent organization of many other organizations like Hamas, Takfir wa Higra from Egypt, Nagur min al-Nar, another terrorist organization from Egypt, Islamic Jihad, the Palestinian one, the Egyptian Jihad, the Nahda in Tunisia, the Muslim Brotherhood in Jordan and Syria, which bred the Jabhat al-Nusra, Boko Haram in Nigeria, and of course Al-Qaeda in North Africa, Al-Qaeda in the Arab Peninsula, Al-Qaeda in Mesopotamia, means in Iraq, Abu Siyaf in the Philippines, and the ISIS, which recently became the IS, Islamic State, Islamic Caliphate, which today we hear about the massacres. And the massacres of today, don't forget, we had the massacre, I don't know, a mile from here, of 9/11, 2001, wasn't this a massacre? Okay, another massacre, another link in the chain, long chain of massacres, which I gave you only a short list of the massacres of the history registered by Muslims. What with London, the 7th of July 2005, Madrid, Bali, Fort Hood was not a massacre. Again, massacres and massacres and massacres, and the Yazidis today. So nobody in the world should be surprised about what happens today, unfortunately, in Iraq. And today the Muslim Brotherhood, which is the mother or parent of all this organization, is viewed by some as a peaceful organization which we all can speak with and come to terms with. Hey, people do not read history, and it's in English also, not only in Arabic. Ladies and gentlemen, the world is sleepwalking, and the free world leaders are asleep at the wheel. Let us all raise the alarm from this place to wake up the world and its leaders, so they see what goes on already 14 centuries. The radical Muslims are on a march to take over the entire Western world, and they say it explicitly, clearly, and they don't even try to hide their intentions. Israel is a bastion on the front line of the mission to save the free world from people who view freedom as their enemy. Thank you very much.
I just want to say that Dr. Kedar flew in from Israel 11 hours this morning, and he's going back tonight. Now my grandmother would call him a ganzer mensch.